Just letting you guys know real quick, I actually have started a podcast with my friend Kyle. You can listen to that if you just click the link in the description. It'll send you to my website. You can get the audio file or you can watch it. The video is on YouTube. We also have blogs on the website, so definitely check that out. And anyways, back to your regularly scheduled video. So the Los Angeles Chargers just announced that they are going to be franchise tagging Hunter Henry, and I think it just makes a ton of sense. Hunter Henry, one healthy, no doubt about it, can be an absolutely fantastic tight end. He's without a doubt definitely more of a pass-catching tight end than he is a blocking tight end. Not an atrocious blocker by any means, but he definitely thrives in the pass-catching aspect of football. And I think that tagging him makes a lot of sense because, as I said, he's fantastic when healthy, but he hasn't stayed healthy a ton. And he's only 25 years old, so maybe a couple of injuries won't matter too much. But at the same time, I do think that getting him to franchise tag, which for tight ends is a little bit over $10 million, it's $10,700,000, it makes sense to me. Give him one more year, see if maybe he can play a full season healthy. And if he does, then you can sign him to a deal. And if not, maybe, you know, he gets another injury, you can kind of just say, okay, thank you for your time here, but we're going to move on because you can't stay healthy. So let's get into what I like about him. One of my favorite things about him is the way that he gets past the linebackers and gets in front of the safeties. It's a very simple thing you will, quite frankly, very often have a tight end do, but he is a guy who can do this very well. And what I mean is a play like this, where what's going to happen is that it's going to be a cover three zone. That's the coverage you see on the screen. And for Henry, he's going to run a simple route right over there. He's going to try to get past the linebackers, but cuts in front of the safety who's deep. It's a simple route you see tight ends do very frequently, but Henry does it a lot because he does it very well. It's something he's very good at. Like, watch. As you see, Henry runs the stem portion of the route very well, so he doesn't give anything away. So when he does cut towards the middle of the field, he definitely is pretty open against that defensive back who is deep. That defensive back's job is to protect the sidelines, so Henry, knowing that, kind of faked as though maybe he was going to go in that direction. So when he does cut towards the middle of the field, he definitely is a little bit open in that aspect. You also see that the Pittsburgh safety is very deep, so this part of the play is working out very well. The other part of the play, though, is that he has to get over the linebackers who are in the middle of the field. Now, what Rivers is going to do is kind of just throw this one up there. He's going to definitely have a lot of air under it. That's kind of what Philip Rivers likes to do on these throws. So the question is going to be, can Hunter Henry adjust to this throw? And he absolutely is going to be able to do it. He runs over and makes the catch. It also really does help that Henry's 6'5", which, you know, you have to be pretty tall to be a tight end, but that really helps when you run those kinds of routes because he's quick enough where he can get that separation against the defensive back, but then he's also tall enough that it's easier to throw over a linebacker when the guy you're throwing it to is taller than the linebacker. The reality is, for the Chargers, I do think one aspect of why you're tagging him instead of signing him to a deal as well is just because you don't exactly know who your quarterback is going to be. Now, I'm sure Los Angeles has some ideas as to who it could be. I mean, maybe they're going to ride things out with Taylor. Maybe they're going to try to sign somebody. And if they are going to try to sign somebody, they might have a good idea of who that is. But either way, I mean, regardless of who you have as a quarterback, those types of plays are necessary just in any system. Every team runs that type of play from time to time. You know, even Baltimore, with how weird their offense is, they'll still run those types of plays. So Henry can fit into any system, no doubt about it. Like, watch. This play is going to be another example. This was against Kansas City, and it's going to be a cover two zone this time, but still similar idea. Henry is running that route right there. Basically, you know, same concept. You often see this kind of thing ran when it's play action. Henry can do it again when it's not against play action, but you won't see teams often do this with play action. But anyways, so you see Henry run over, and at this point, he is going to be way less open than he was last time. Not that he was wide open last time, but he was pretty open. This time, however, since it is a situation where Kansas City is making sure that they protect that first down marker, this now means that there's going to be players a lot further deep that are covering the midfield. So if you look at those two Kansas City players, they are right in the area where this is not going to be a huge window. So you might think, okay, don't make this type of throw. Rivers should look somewhere else. However, Rivers again says, I have a 6'5 guy and there is a window, but it's going to get even bigger when I have a guy like Hunter Henry who can make this catch. So he's going to put air under it and basically just let his great player make a great play. That's a really good play from Hunter Henry. But what's even more impressive was Rivers trusted that Henry could make that play because he makes those plays so frequently. That's why if you're Los Angeles, you have to, at the very least, tag him because you can't let him go anywhere. Another way that Henry can be very effective is in the red zone. And, you know, that's where you need a tight end, especially a pass-catching tight end, to be effective is in the red zone. And Henry absolutely can be. He's a great guy to have on your fantasy team because he will get touchdowns if he's healthy. So he's a big high-risk, high-reward type of guy, really. But let's take a look at this play, for example, where it's going to be a cover two man type play, and that's going to be Henry's route. Pretty simple route, run over the middle. He could get in between the safeties, and if he can beat his assigned man, he absolutely could be open in the middle of the field, no doubt about it. But after the ball is snapped, you notice that his assigned man right here, the defensive back, he's pretty much thinking right here, okay, I know that there is going to be a gap in the middle of the field towards the end zone where maybe they could be trying to make this play, so I'm just not going to let Henry get in that area. You know, if Henry cuts to the outside, cuts to the corner, that's fine, I have help there. I don't have help over the middle, so I'm just going to make sure that I don't allow him to beat me over the middle. I actually suspect that Henry's route was supposed to cut a little bit further, but what Henry does right here is he realizes, okay, if I wait too long, I'm just going to get pushed out of the way, and you know, they almost never call hand fighting in the end zone, so that's a dangerous situation. If I just keep running forward, I could take myself out of the play. I don't want to do that. So instead, before he even enters the end zone, he's then going to cut, gets to the inside, and at that point, when you have a 6'5 body standing in front of a defensive back, that's just too easy of a throw for Rivers to make. Just a good play by Henry and was able to use his big body to get in front and make that catch. And there's not too much you can do as a defensive back against that. There really isn't. One more play that I think will really just show how good he can be and how dangerous he can be, especially in the red zone, is a play like this where it's man coverage. There's a couple of double teams. However, neither of those double teams are going to be on Henry. One of them is going to be over the middle of the field, but Henry is running that route right there. And so this is going to force a one-on-one matchup since, as a Kansas City player, your job is to make sure you cover whoever's in the middle of the field, but he's going to end up covering Keenan Allen. So this now leaves Henry with a one-on-one matchup. And if he can win this one-on-one matchup, it could work out very well. And watch basically just this first part of the route and watch how he does such a good job of selling that beginning portion. You know, he gets his assigned man, Daniel Sorensen, right here to totally believe that that's where he's going. He's going to the bottom half of the screen, running a flat route, which is something you often do against this type of situation as well. So it does make sense that he might be running this route. And so when he cuts to the top half of the screen, he is able to make the catch, even reaches out, which, you know, I don't love. I don't love when you reach out to get to the goal line. But hey, if it works out, it works out. He gets the touchdown. So that's what Hunter Henry can do. He's a great red zone target, and he's very good also over the middle of the field. Really good receiving tight end. And he's just one of those guys that I think you have to keep. I mean, again, the injury history is a concern, which is why I love the franchise tag. And if you give him a long-term deal, it's dangerous for sure. And maybe you could say that you give him a long-term deal with very little penalty for cutting him due to an injury. But I don't know. I think the tag makes sense and just give him an extra year. Also worth noting right now, the Chargers currently have about $40 million in cap space. And most of their guys are pretty signed up right now. It kind of makes me think, yes, they could go after a quarterback in free agency, or they could just go all out to try to fix that offensive line. You know, there are some good offensive linemen in free agency this year. And then just, you know, ride things out with Tyrod Taylor. I think you could absolutely do that. That's just a thought I had, but it does kind of make some sense, I think. It would all depend on who's available and how much you could afford to pay them, but that's definitely something on the table for the Chargers, I think. But in terms of the Henry deal, absolutely makes sense. Absolutely what I would have done. Give him a tag, let him play for one more year, and then you can evaluate him next year, or just give him a long-term deal if you feel like that's necessary. But I think let's give him a year and then let's give him the deal. That's just my opinion. I'd like to know what you guys think. And of course, as always, thanks for watching.